So this webinar will be focusing on how you can use Notion in everyday practice. This will give you some real life examples of how Notion is being used day to day and hopefully inspire you and your Notion account. Before we begin, for those curious about what Notion is very simply a new type of productivity software. Unlike applications like Evernote and Trello, Notion gives you total freedom to what you build inside of the application. It's best described as a personal and team wiki, allowing you to create areas or spaces inside of your account to meet whatever need you have. So for example, inside of Notion, if I wanted to take simple notes, I could using the list database ability. If I wanted to go ahead and manage a project, I could use the boards feature in there too. And if I wanted to start creating a useful guide for my team to follow, I can add text, useful formatting, and also videos as well. So the amazing thing is, Notion is an application that you can mold to any of your situations, and that's what makes it very special and very attractive to many new users. Now there's no doubt that Notion takes a little bit of time to learn because you're developing some of these skills from scratch, but once you get a good idea of the application and how you can use it in day-to-day practice, you'll really soar with Notion. So we're going to break things up into three different sections. We're going to talk about use cases. In section two, I'm going to give you a little bit of a tour of a working Notion account. And then in section three, we're going to talk specifically about the brand new template feature, which will save you huge amounts of time. So let's start with section one, and that's the different use cases of Notion. So as you can see, I'm on our account here, and I have three examples that I'd like to show you. This hopefully will give you a few inspirations of how you can apply your Notion account. These have all been copied from the templates area, but will give you a good idea of how this can be used in day-to-day practice. The first of those is a recipe book. Now this here is a recipe book, and it allows you to essentially see all of the recipes that you have in your list. Now, as you can see, this is a nice photo gallery of all of the different recipes I want. But I can also click in and see more details. For example, whether this can be used, for example, as a dinner in the slow cooker and what type of meal it is. I can also see a link back to the actual direct ingredients and recipe that I can follow. And down here as well, I can give it a star rating and also yield and total time that it will take to cook. These are all things that you can build into your Notion account very, very easily just by going ahead and adding a property. Down below here, inside of the card details, you can see the ingredients and also the preparation information. Now this is really useful, and I think as many home cooks will know, this is a great way to be able to see everything at a glance. And when you want to find a recipe, be able to find it in one place that can be consistently updated. If I wanted, I could go to the top left-hand corner and press open as page, allowing me to see this as a separate page so I can view it in more detail. If, for example, I cooked it and I wanted to be able to edit some of the details, for example, I knew that I wanted to change the time to, for example, 5 hours, I could go here and change it to 5 hours. So the great thing about Notion is you can manually edit everything, and it makes it so easy to do so. If I go back to the recipes area, I can find all of the recipes. And the great thing is there are some filters that allow me to chop things down. So for example, if I only wanted to see the dinners that are available in this list, I could press add filter, choose the tag section, and press contains dinner. And as you can see, all of the features that are available for dinner become viewable. So essentially, I can see here all of the meals that I could cook for dinner. And I can do that with other such areas. For example, using that same feature, I go to filter and contains breakfast. And as you can see, there are only 3 items here that I can cook for breakfast, but I can click into them and find all of the relevant information. For example, how to prepare them and get the ingredients ready. So this is a great example of how I could use a recipe board inside of Notion. And the great thing is it's so flexible to all of the features that you have, and you can add whatever properties, whatever areas, and whatever abilities you like to your recipes book. Going back out of this, let's show you another area that might be useful. That is the habit tracker. This is a great way to keep track of your daily habits and keep organized, as well as being able to see a good outline of what you actually went and completed. So as you can see here, this is a nice table view, allowing me to see all of the days of the month ahead. So for example, you can see here they have columns for workout, meditation, read and no phone in bed, and bed by 10:30, as well as a host more that I'll be able to track using this habit tracker. So for example, let's say I skip to the 15th of April and I said, okay, I worked out today and I also did read and no phone in bed and also bed by 10:30. You can see here I've ticked these off quite visually, and this is a great way in being able to see what habits you've completed and haven't completed for the month. So this can easily be created with a table database view. And it really doesn't take long to be able to add the columns and also checkboxes. The way that you do that is once you create a column, you don't go ahead and select the text property type, you change it to checkbox property type so that you can track the status using this checkbox. So you could be using it as your recipes area, your habit tracker, but what other experiences can you use? So if I go back to home, let's touch on the third example. That third example is the weekly agenda, and this can be used to organize the week ahead and also plan in advance. Now you can design this to whatever needs you want, but this is a great example that Notion provided on their templates page. For example, these are the 5 days ahead, and I can be able to add tasks to what's called a to-do list block. This allows me to create a simple checkbox and add a task, and it can even theme the day as well, and also add any other additional to-dos. So this is a great example page of how I could use a weekly agenda to plan my week ahead. Now it's quite cool because there's milestone tracking, also the most important things I need to get done, as well as a view on, for example, week reflection down here, outstanding tasks, and also a habit tracker as well. So this can actually be copied from the Notion templates area, which we'll be touching on at the end of this video. So you can get a sort of an idea now, for example, the many different use cases that you can apply to Notion. So let's start section 2, where we jump into a tour of my Notion account, giving you a bit of an idea of how Notion can be used in everyday practice. Now, if you're worrying and you're watching along going, how would I even create this area? We'll touch on that in section 3 with copying from the templates area. The templates area will save you valuable time and also effort in developing some of these templates, and you can also still customize them to your needs. So here we are on my own home area, and as you can imagine, I've been using Notion for a little bit of time now to organize and plan most of my week. So you can see here I've got two separate sections. I've got life and work. Inside of life, I have things from diet and fitness to our house, inspiration, finance, and other such areas. In work, I also have all the projects, travel, tax, and payments that are coming up. I find this separation and actually using the homepage to separate life and work actually helps me to get organized. So the first page I'd like to show you is inside of our home area, where we've been planning what we'd like to see in all of our rooms. So if I click in, I go now to the rooms area. Now, as you can see, this is very similar to the recipes book that we created earlier. As you can see, I've added images to each of the rooms that we're planning to have. And as you can see, everything from the hallway to the kitchen. Now, the great thing is we need to know what we're actually buying for each of these rooms. So for example, if I clicked in to the office and bedroom, I could see all of the essentials that we need to buy and how much it will cost. I've also added a few links below the image. And this is super duper helpful because I can see everything all at a glance. We've even got property areas to type in the theme of the room and also what wallpaper we want to have. So we're getting a good idea of what we want to see. We've replicated this for pretty much every room, so let's see the main bedroom. You can see here the theme will be navy blue and white, very similar to this image, but just below it we can see all of the essentials that we need to buy for that room and a few of the links that we've already saved. So this has been a great way to keep track of all of the different rooms and all of the things that we need to get for those rooms. We've also got additional stuff. For example, if you click in, you can see the extras and the flooring prices below. So we found this a great way to keep track of all that we need. And even we're going to use this list here as a way to see all of the stuff we need to buy in IKEA. So moving on to the next area, which is inbox. Now I have two core inboxes, one for inspiration, things that I think I'd like to save for later that will inspire me, and also articles to read. Let's go into articles to read. As you can see here, I've got a full track of all the articles that I want to read in the next couple of weeks. I use the Notion Web Clipper, which is available through the Chrome Web Store, to save any articles. And this is really, really easy to do. So all I need to do is go to the Chrome Web Store, sign into Google, download the Notion Web Clipper, and if I'm on any article or page, I can go ahead and press Notion. Once I've saved this, I make sure to save it to the database created articles to read, so that I can read them all for later. Now this is perfect. If I click in, I can see a bit of an outline on the article, the author, and much more details about the piece. But the great thing is, I can find the URL and get started straight away. Now just a note, the Notion Web Clipper isn't as good as the Evernote Web Clipper per se, but it does a good job at clipping basic articles. The final area I want to show you is actually inside a different workspace. So as you can see here, I have two separate workspaces, one for myself and one for our team. Inside of our team area, we keep a good track of all of the things that we need to know about it. And for example, if I click in YouTube calendar, I can see all of the upcoming articles and pieces that I want to post out on YouTube. So you can see here that I want to be able to post this one, the Microsoft Teams intro, and be able to update this. So this is a very, very simple boards view, and it allows me to see all of the different cards that I'll be creating. And I can drag them, like Trello, between the statuses that I'll be working on. So this is a perfect experience if I'm able to be able to manage and organize some of my content. And I share this with the team in case that we need to share or even assign pieces to other people. And if I wanted to as well, I could go ahead and type in and search this board for anything in particular. Let's say I wanted to see all of the GTD pieces coming up. I can see them both there. So this was a little bit of an outline of how I use Notion, but let's touch on the final section, which is talking to you about the new templates ability. So on the web browser, if I go ahead and type in notion.so/templates, this is a new area that Notion has created dedicated to helping you find the most suitable template. So here are the ones that have been recently added. All I can do is browse all of the templates that is available, and this is really useful. So for example, if I wanted to go ahead and copy the OKRs, this might be useful for team situations. I can go and preview what they look like. Let's say I'm pretty happy with that. Then I can go to the OKRs area here. Now, once I'm in here, it's really great because I can see what this looks like in practice. And of course, the great thing is, if I copy this to my own area, it won't affect the original document. So if I go to the top right-hand corner and press duplicate, I can duplicate it into the keep productive area. And as you can see, it's being automatically pasted. Now, most of these new areas go into the private area, so all I'd have to do is drag this into the relevant page that I want. Now, it gives me a notification in whether I want to actually share it with all of the three members already in the workspace, and I'm pretty happy with that. So the great thing is now I can go in and edit and change it to my own needs without affecting the original database. So of course the templates gallery, which can be found at notion.so/templates, is really useful. But as you can imagine, it's also important to learn the skills of creating a page from scratch. So of course, make sure to learn about the many features of Notion and take a full advantage of the application. One thing I'd also say is if you have an idea for a page, it's worth just playing around with the many block abilities that Notion has. And don't be worried about making mistakes as you get started with your Notion account. So guys, hopefully this gave you a good idea of how you can apply Notion to everyday activities. Please do let me know if you've got any questions, but I look forward to answering some of your questions now. Cheers, guys.